that's a little creepy. A man you don't really know just came to the door, so he knows exactly where you live and he knows you're alone in your rig. I am revisiting a place that I first came to.
Continue on New Mexico 392 West for 16 miles.
There you know, I'm in New Mexico. I'm revisiting a place that I first came to in 2020. I did quite an extensive video involving this place. And when I saw the signs that I was near it, I just thought
Head southwest on Frontage Road, 4132, Key Road 58.5, Torquay County Road F.
She doesn't realize where I'm going.
Continue on Frontage Road 4132 for 14 miles.
She needs to chill out because I am at Russell's Travel Center. Russell's Travel Center, if you saw the video that I did on it, you know that Russell's Travel Center has a car museum, among many other exciting things, right inside of it. And it's quite a place. I'm happy to be back visiting again. I don't know that I'm going to spend quite as much time here because I think I stayed in the parking lot last time. I'm not going to do that, but this place is a fantastic dog park for one thing, and I'm going to go look at the cars. I'll show you a little bit. I'm not going to remake the same video I made before. Russell's Travel Center. It's a great place. Check it out next time you're on the road.
You know, I was thinking, why didn't I come into this dog park the last time? And then I realized I didn't have a dog last time I was here. It was in the month between Cowboy and Captain. I don't think it would have been the same experience if I had, though, because you hear these birds? They probably wouldn't have been here, or if they were, I don't think they'd be making so many crazy sounds. Some of them sound like they're mimicking car alarms. These are grackles. Coincidentally, I did a video about grackles before, too, also in 2020, when I was at the Walmart in Amarillo, where there were hundreds of them. Grackles are always pretty loud, but there's even more noise than usual because this time of year, May to July, is mating season. Some of this is the sound of courting. Grackles are monogamous, so a male and female will sing for each other, then dance for each other, then shack up together to make little baby grackles. They're not super territorial, so it's not really that weird to see a group of them nesting together. I count at least 15 nests in this one tree. Like a grackle condo building, but there can be up to 200 pairs all nesting together.
Personally, I don't think I'd be too into nesting that close to everybody else. I mean, I love the community, but I'd probably be in a tree on the other side of the parking lot, and I definitely wouldn't be doing a mating dance, because, yeah, those days are over for me.
Okay, Captain.
Let's go check out the inside, like, just for a minute. This is the cafe. It's kind of a little diner-y kind of place. And then there's Subway and some other food options. And then the store has a really wide variety of stuff. And then of course there's a section catering to truckers' needs. Here's the entrance to the car museum, but I'm not gonna go through it today. If you wanna see it, I'll put a link to the other video at the end of this one. The showers here are great, but I'm not gonna take one now because I wanna get to this campsite. It looks really beautiful and I'm afraid it's gonna be crowded, so I wanna make sure I get a spot.
I know you're searching. I see lightning in your eyes so deep, eyes so deep.
Oh wow, it is beautiful. And it definitely doesn't look crowded.
And I see you floating in the breeze. Wishfully hoping for something sweet to soothe your insides.
Okay.
Captain, come with me. Wherever I'm going, he doesn't want to go today. I don't know why. I guess we're having a feud. Here he comes. He's just taking his sweet time. Okay, so I gotta do this carrying a dog. An old lady carrying a dog walking down a rocky little trail. Oh look, somebody's building a little fence, a little wall here. Nice. Now if you were a tent camper, this would be fantastic. Just don't roll out of bed.
people writing their names. Welcome to America.
Oh, look at that little guy.
I hope he's friendly because looks like he's coming this way. Hi. Oh, you're not lost, are you, buddy?
See, he's the right size for cats. Don't you wish humans could make friends that easy? Just, you know, sniff a butt and you're buddies. Could be from the Class A up there on the top, or there's a family in a red pickup truck over that way, and then there's a guy fishing down by the edge. Oh, I guess the dog does belong to the fisherman. So that was the fisherman's dog. And we chatted for a little while, but I turned off the camera because if you're possibly going to put somebody in a video, you kind of have to tell them that. And then I have to tell them I have a YouTube channel. And then it just gets weird, you know. So a lot of times I'm not real comfortable asking people if they're willing to be in a video. So a lot of times I just don't shoot other people, you know, or I aim the camera at the ground and maybe pick up a little bit of audio and you can't tell who it is. And I kind of wish I had done that this time because I swear to God, that guy was flirting with me. I mean, I'm not 100% sure, but I think he was. I wish you could have heard it so you could tell me if you thought so too. But at my age, that doesn't really happen very often. You know, I kind of feel invisible a lot of the time. So that felt kind of good.
There's a glorious horizon you can set your sights on now. Waves of color, they surround you. You sing your city set to.
Do not put your fish in the dumpster. I don't know if I mentioned that this is Ute State Park, and this is a primitive camping area. I thought it was free, but when I went into the bathrooms, they have, you know, basic vault toilets here. And when I went in there was a sign on the door that said it was $8 to camp here. And, you know, $8 is a bargain, but I just didn't know. Supposedly there's a box you put the money in, but I don't know where the box is. I haven't seen any box anywhere.
And there goes the sun. So I was just about to make dinner when I heard this knock on the door. I thought it was going to be the ranger because I didn't pay my $8 yet, but it was that fisherman. When we were talking before, I mentioned that I didn't know where I was going to go next. You know, I was trying to figure out what the next stop was going to be, and he thought about it. He had a suggestion, so he just stopped by. And I know some of you are thinking, oh, that's a little creepy. A man you don't really know just came to the door, so he knows exactly where you live and he knows you're alone in your rig. And I can understand that thought. I can, because I'm a woman traveling alone and you do have to be careful. But the guy liked talking to me. He wanted to talk to me a little more. Does that make him creepy? No, it just makes him a guy. I feel safe most of the time. And I think for me, that's pretty much a choice. I mean, I don't ignore the vibe if it isn't good, and I don't think that my intuition is infallible, but I would really prefer to err on the side of trust. Maybe that's going to backfire on me someday, but I just can't run around assuming that every guy is Ted Bundy or Harvey Weinstein, because that's not fair and it's not fun. I don't want to live in fear. And I'm not going to. I'm going to sleep very well tonight, unless, of course, that guy comes back to kill me. That's a joke. Good morning. I am still alive. The fisherman did not return to serial kill me. I was thinking about what I said last night, and I just want to clarify. I'm not trying to say that there's anything wrong with wanting to hang out with the women.
you know, surround yourself with women. I'm just saying there's nothing wrong either in being open to people who are not women. In fact, some of the kindest and most fun people that I've met out here have been men, you know? And I understand why everybody has different life experiences. You know, you have to do what makes you comfortable. And I do understand why somebody might want to go to the women's RTR. Personally, I like the regular RTR. I like mixed company. I like men. And I'm not talking about sex or romance. I'm just saying it's a different energy, you know? I like that energy. I had a perfectly nice conversation with a not unattractive guy who seems to think that I am not unattractive too, and there was nothing creepy about it. I got a mating dance. I mean, I'm not in the market. I'm not looking to make a nest or anything, but maybe I should be more open. I don't know. I just enjoy a good flirt every now and then, and not every mating dance has to end in a nest. So things to feel good about. Beautiful spot. Captain is happy. No ranger at the door, and I'm not as invisible as I thought.
Shut you in a coat, trust the sun to keep you warm as you pass under the clouds.